Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Friends, today we are going to discuss this numerical problem which is based on a simply supported beam, and we have to draw the bending moment and shear force diagram for this simply supported beam. First of all, let us see what is this load W doing to this simply supported beam. This load W is acting at a distance of xy4 from this point. So because of this load W, there will be a moment in this direction acting at this point having magnitude W into this distance x by 4. Okay, and because of this movement M, this movement M can be transferred further to this point B, and it will act in this direction, that is clockwise direction, having same magnitude as written here, WxY4. Okay, now we can generate this beam and we can draw an equivalent beam for this simply supported beam to make the analysis simple. So for that, we are drawing a new beam here. Okay. So friends, we have drawn this beam and it is equivalent to this beam. Okay. And we can see that this moment is acting at this point B. Sorry, this point is B actually, and this is C. Okay. So this moment is acting at this point B, and this load can be transferred without affecting the system over here at this point B. We are transferring this load. So now we have to draw the shear force and the bending moment diagram for this beam. Now first step is to find out the reactions at the point A and the point C. So the reactions, let us suppose that reaction at A is vertical in opposite, in vertically upward direction, and reaction at C is acting in vertically upward direction. Now using the equation that RA plus RC is equal to 0. Why? Because the sum of these two reactions is equal to net vertical load acting over this beam. Sorry, it is not equal to 0. It will be equal to W. Why? Because there is a W load acting over this beam, which is acting in vertical direction. That's why RA plus RC is equal to W. And the second reaction is summation of movement about the point A is equal to 0, because point A will act as a hinge. You can take movement about point C is equal to 0 also, but that will also give the same result. I am taking movement about the point A as 0. Now, because of this RC, there will be a moment of magnitude, that is magnitude RC into this distance between AC is X, okay, and it will try to rotate this beam AC about point A in anti-clockwise direction, okay, and anti-clockwise here we assume that it is positive anti-clockwise movement. Now this load W is trying to rotate this beam in clockwise direction about the point A, so this will give us the magnitude of this load W into this distance between AB is x by 2, so into x by 2. Okay, and because of this movement, there will be a movement about point A which will try to rotate this beam element AB in clockwise direction. So clockwise is again treated as negative, so it will give us WxY4 with negative sign in clockwise direction. So it will give us 0. Now, when you solve this, then what will you get? You will get RC is equal to 3W/4. Okay? And when you substitute this RC in this equation, that is the equation number 1, you can name this, then you will get RA is equal to W/4. Okay, now we will draw the shear force diagram for this. Now for that, we have to calculate the shear force at the point A, B and C. We will calculate the shear force on the left side of the point A and on the right side of the point A, on the left side of the point B and on the right side of the point B, on the left side of the point C and on the right side of the point C. Now first we will calculate shear force on the left side of the point A. For that, we have to follow the same procedure that I have already told you in the previous video lectures. We have to draw a section here on the left side of this point A. For that, And you can look on the left side of this section, the value of shear force is zero because there is no force lying which will contribute toward the shear force of this section xx. Now, shear force on the right side of the point A we have to find out. For that, we have to again draw a section on the right side of the point A. Okay. Now, see on the left side of this section, this force is contributing toward a positive shear force using this sign convention. This is the section xx, this is the section xx, and this force is acting on the left side of this section and going in of what direction? So, treat it as positive here. So, it will give us a shear force of magnitude Ra, and Ra is equal to how much? Wy4. So, plus Wy4 we will get. And on the left side of the point B, if you want to find out the shear force, then construct a section here on the left side of the point B. Okay, here constructed. Now, on the left side of this section, you can see that only this force is lying which will contribute toward the shear force. So, using this sign convention again, it will give us again positive shear force of magnitude Ra, and Ra is equal to Wy4. Now, shear force on the right side of the point B, if you want to find out, then again we have to draw a section on the right side of the point B. And by drawing the section here on the right side of the point B, you can see on looking on the left side of this section, this force is contributing toward a positive shear force of magnitude Ra, and Ra is equal to Wy4. Using this sign convention, and this force is contributing toward a negative shear force using this sign convention. Okay, so it will give us a shear force of minus W of this magnitude, and it will give us minus 3W/4. Now, shear force on the left side of the point we want to determine. So again, we have to construct a section on the left side of the point C, and looking on the left side of this section, you can see this force is contributing toward a shear force of magnitude Ra, and according to this sign convention, it is taken as positive. So, Wy4 taken here, and this is contributing toward negative shear force of minus W using this sign convention. Okay, so it will again give us minus 3Wy4. Okay, now on the right side of the point C, if you want to calculate the shear force, then we have to draw a section on the right side of the point C and look for the various forces acting on the left side of this section xx. So, looking on the left side of this section, this force is contributing toward a positive shear force of magnitude Wy4. This is contributing to a negative shear force of minus W, and it is contributing toward a positive shear force using this sign convention of magnitude Rc, and Rc is how much? Plus 3W/4. It will give us 0. So, now we will draw the shear force diagram. Now see, we are drawing shear force diagram. This is the beam ABC drawn here by projecting this point ABC over here over this line. Above this line, we can treat the shear force as positive, and below this line, we can treat the shear force as negative. So on the left side of the point A, shear force is zero. So making a cross here at 0 point. And on the right side of the point A, it is going to plus Wy4. Okay, plus Wy4 above this point. And on the left side of the point B, it is again Wy4 lying in the same level. Okay, and on the right side of the point B, it is going to minus 3Wy4. Minus 3Wy4 will lie somewhere here. Minus 3Wy4 immediately below the point B. And on the left side of the point C, it is going to minus 3Wy4. So, lie in the same level, minus 3Wy4. Minus 3Wy4. And on the right side of the point C, it is going to 0. So, joining first point with the second. Second point is joined with the third point with a straight line, because there is no load lying between point A and B in the loading diagram. And again joining third point with the fourth point, and fourth point with the fifth point, and fifth point with the sixth point, we will get our shear force diagram. Now we will draw the bending moment diagram. Now we will calculate the bending moment at the point A, B and C. Remember, we have to calculate the bending moment on the left side of the point B and on the right side of the point B. Why? Because there is a concentrated movement is acting at the point B. That's why bending movement will change suddenly when going from the left side of the point B to the right side of the point B. And we will calculate the bending moment at the point A and C directly by constructing section at the point A and C. Now, see this. Bending moment at the point A. For that, we have to construct a section here at the point A. Okay, this is the section xx constructed here. Now, see this, friends. On the left side of this section, there is no force lying. That's why shear force is zero at the point A. And on the right side of the point B, if you want to find out the shear force, then we have to construct a section on the left side of the point B. If we want to find out the shear force, then we have to construct a section on the left side of this point B. And looking on the left side of the section, this force is contributing toward a positive, sorry, this force is contributing toward a positive bending moment. Okay, using this sign convention. Okay, because this moment is, this force is causing concavity up for this section A, for this beam AB about this section XX as shown here. Like this, you can compare this figure, this portion with this sign convention. So you will get the magnitude of bending moment as RA, this the value of RA is W by 4 into this distance between AB, that is X. Okay, X by 2. Okay, and it will give us positive bending moment using this sign convention. Now, bending moment on the left side of the point, on the right side of the point B, if you want to find out, then we have to construct a section here on the right side of the point B. And looking on the left side of this section, then you can see that this force is contributing toward a positive bending moment about this section XX, having the same magnitude as W by 4 into X by 2 using this sign convention. And this movement, concentrated movement, is causing a bending moment of magnitude plus WX by 4. This plus WX by 4. Plus, why taken plus? Because on the left side, a movement which is lying on the left side of a section and going in anti-clockwise direction is treated as positive. Similar is the condition here. Okay, this movement is lying on the left side of the section axis and going clockwise direction. That's why treated here as positive, using this sign convention. Now, the bending moment because of this force is zero. Why? Because distance of this force from this section XX nearly equal to zero. So, because of this, it will be zero. Now, bending moment at the point C, we can find out by constructing a section at the point C. Okay, now you can see that looking on the left side of this section, this force is contributing toward a bending moment of plus W by 4, that is the magnitude of this force, into this distance between AC, that is X, and this force is contributing toward a bending moment of minus magnitude of this force into this distance between the BC is XY2. Because using this sign convention, by using this sign convention, we have treated here NOG negative, okay, this bending moment, and because of this concentrated movement, there is really a movement of plus WXY4 using this sign convention. So it will come out to be how much? Zero. Now friends, what we have to do, sorry, this is coming, this is WXY4, okay, okay, everything is okay, it is coming out to be zero. Now we will draw the bending moment diagram. Now see, the bending moment at the point A is zero, so making cross here, and the bending moment on the left side of the point B is WXY8, so it will lie somewhere here, suppose, which is WX by 8, this term lie will here. And bending moment on the right side of the point B is 3WX by 8, so it will lie somewhere here above this point, which is 3WX by 8, okay, and the bending moment at C is 0. So joining first point with the second by an inclined line, why? Because the shear force diagram between these point, these two points A and B is a horizontal line, that's why it is an inclined line. And joining second with the third and third with the fourth is again joined with the inclined line, using the same conclusion that the shear force diagram is a horizontal line between the point B and C, that's why it is an inclined line between B and C. So this was all for today's topic, friend. If you like my video, you can subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the notification of the upcoming videos. Thank you, friend, for watching the video.